Hello and welcome to Fortify Unplugged. I'm Carl Sahaki, and today I'm going to be discussing how you can reduce noise with Fortify. So first, I think it's important for us to discuss what noise is. So what is noise? So noise to us, we consider noise to be all output considered irrelevant or not worth acting upon by users. If noise isn't kept in check, it can have negative effects on implementation. This can mean that security auditors end up swamped in audit work. If results are being pushed directly to the developers, they may lose confidence in the tool. And it can also stand in the way of a rapid DevSecOps scenario where developers process results directly. When talking about noise, it's important to make a distinction. So this Venn diagram shows noise as both false positives in the pink circle, as well as issues that may be irrelevant due to environmental issues or a number of other reasons, things like risk appetite, or maybe context in the orange circle, with true positives being in the green. Now, false positives are something that we do work constantly to reduce, but a much larger percentage of what we would consider noise falls in the orange circle. While this orange circle is harder for us to eliminate, we do provide tools that can help you to reduce it. And that's primarily what I'm going to be covering today. If we look at it in a bit more detail, everything listed as not an issue in this green box here can be broken down further into a number of categories. So we have false positives, which again is where a security expert would identify something reported by Fortify as being incorrectly identified as an issue. But it could also be things that are more on the organizational preference side or software quality issues, things that are typically reported as low risk issues that you might otherwise choose to ignore. Now, noise can also be based on application context that makes particular issues either not exploitable or maybe unreachable. Unfortunately, Fortify is unable to know these things from a scan alone, so additional things need to be done, which I'll get into in a second. One thing to note is that noise cannot be fully eliminated from an analysis tool because it's often context dependent. Another reason is if you limit the scope to false positives, you run the risk of increasing false negatives or what we would consider a true issue. So all detection technologies, whether we're talking about static testing or any technology that detects things, can make two primary types of errors. So that would be false positives and false negatives. These depend on the confidence threshold that you configure your technology with. If you demand a high confidence threshold, false positives do decrease. But inversely, as you see here, false negatives will increase as well. So some tools do play with this and they eliminate rules that have lower thresholds. While this does reduce noise, it comes at the cost of finding true positives or inversely by increasing your false negatives. Fortify does prioritize avoiding false negatives and instead offers extensive mechanisms to make noise more manageable while still keeping your scan integrity. So now we know what noise is, how do we combat that? How do we fight that noise? So this is an overview of the tools that we have available and the flow that we go through when we scan. So we start with a code base, then we run a static analysis. You get something called a Fortify project result or FPR file, and then that gets uploaded to Software Security Center. Often organizations are only using human review and then state that they have too much noise. There are steps that you can take long before you get to human review to make things much easier for you and your team. So during scanning, you have three options. You can use filter files, and I'm going to go through each of these in the coming slides, but you can use filter files, you can use file extension exclusions, or custom rules. So post-scan in Software Security Center, you can use extensive filters as well as Audit Assistant to help you combat that noise as well. For Fortify on-demand customers, all of this can be completed behind the scenes, and customers can receive the human review aspect performed by our team of experts as well. So first, let's go over the early options. So these are things that you can do either before you scan or during scanning. So those three things would be filter files, file exclusions, and custom rules. So the first pre-scan option is filter files. Filter files are an early way that you can reduce noise. So these are a standard feature in SCA, and instructions can be found within your SCA guide. If you do not have an SCA guide, simply Google SCA guide and then the version number, and you should be able to find a guide hosted for you. Essentially, these are text files you can create with any text editor that function as a blacklist and then filter out the items specified. So these are configured per scan and can be specified to the following three types. You can specify by category, rule ID, or instance ID. The first two are relevant to fighting noise, whereas instance IDs can be useful for other reasons, but not so much for filtering noise, so we aren't going to spend very much time talking about that today. So the two main things you can filter for during the scan are categories and rule IDs. So categories could be things like poor style, value never read, and can be useful when you want to suppress a group of issues that you would consider below your radar. If a category is truly noise for your organization, this is a reliable approach that doesn't typically lead to any sort of increase in false negatives. Alternatively, you can also filter based on rule IDs. This is a more granular approach than filtering by category and can be useful when a rule affects multiple categories, like in the case of a pass-through rule. When you are using this method, you do need to be sure to understand why a rule needs to be suppressed, as this can cause false negatives. So you do want to be careful with excluding by rule IDs. If you're using Fortify on demand, we do have something similar called audit templates. These use an if-then statement to accomplish much of the same things, and this is found under the administration tab and then the advanced audit tools side tab within your portal. Another method that you can use before scanning is file exclusions, and there are a few parameters to do so. Some specific cases would be maybe excluding .NET disabled projects, or if you have JavaScript or Node.js, there are cases where libraries might get imported, which could lead to a lot of noise, and these can be suppressed as well. File exclusions can be risky at times. Here we have some cases of what would be considered safe and what would be considered risky. One thing to note is if you're using Maven or other tools, some certain other tools, this may self-identify as testing code and automatically be eliminated from scanning. But if it's not, you can also manually exclude it. The main point you want to be aware of here is the code that you're excluding code on which the rest of the code base does not depend on? If so, then it might be safe to exclude. This would be things like testing code, utility code, or sometimes third-party libraries. You do want to make sure that you're avoiding excluding code that is part of the main code base, so things like generated code. This can disrupt data flow detection and can also cause warnings and false negatives that you would prefer to avoid. In this case, you'd be better off with post-scan filtering, which I'll cover later. Another option that you have is to write custom rules. So in general, these are used to either find more issues or to find less issues or less noise. So today we'll be focusing on the latter, so using custom rules to find less issue or reduce noise. So in general, there are three rules that you can write to reduce noise. There are suppression rules, data flow cleanse rules, and then suppressing rules and replacing them with more specific custom rules, which is more of a method there. But with suppression rules, these eliminate a rule from Fortify processing and in fact are very similar to filtering by rule ID, like I mentioned earlier. There's also data flow cleanse rules as well. In general, a source will receive a taint flag that will then follow through functions if external data is not validated or sanitized. Data flow cleanse rules work for the data flow analysis algorithm by explaining to Fortify that if data goes through a particular function, it removes the taint and is then safe from certain types of attacks. Now, the third mechanism here is through suppressing a standard rule and then replacing it with a more specific rule that better fits your organization. I don't necessarily recommend this option, and if you do choose to go this route, please provide your input to Fortify support so that they can assist if necessary, and also to take notes on how that we can improve Fortify. Now, users can directly create a data flow cleanse rule from scratch or from Audit Workbench, which is a tool that's shipped with SCA. Or they can also use our custom rules editor as well. So just as a disclaimer, this example here is one that I made up, and there is no sanitation or validation here. So you'll want to make sure that you do have that in a real world example. But if you are using Audit Workbench to create data flow cleanse rules, you need to first identify the sanitization or validation method that's being invoked in the analysis trace on the left. Then you'll want to right click on the method name. So in this case, it's the get raw parameter. And then you would select generate rule for function. You would follow the steps given in the wizard and fill in all of the appropriate fields. And then lastly, in the screenshot above, in the next step, you have to specify where the taint is removed, either the return value or a parameter. So this is an XML, and the easiest way that you can create this is by using the wizard with our custom rules editor, or what I prefer is through Audit Workbench, as there's a little more options that way. Now, if you're using Fortify on demand, you can also use data flow cleanse rules. Users can use the interface within Fortify on demand to do so. Alternatively, we can also take in XML rule files and then apply them to scans done in Fortify on demand. If anybody would like to see more information on data flow cleanse rules in action or just see how to do them, please check this channel, so the same channel that this is posted on, to see how-to videos that we'll go through in detail. Okay, so we've talked about some of the pre-scan or during scan options. So let's talk about ways that you can filter noise post-scan. So the main two ways of doing that would be Audit Assistant and then filters through either Audit Workbench or Software Security Center. So as I mentioned, there are also options to reduce noise post-scan. So this is actually where I prefer to start when I'm looking at reducing noise. On the software security side, after you've uploaded a Fortify project result or FPR, a noise reduction tool that we offer is called Audit Assistant. Audit Assistant is an on-premise machine learning solution that has been fed by years of metadata from manual audits on our cloud solution that can then apply predictions on whether an issue is a true positive or a false positive. So over the years of developing this, it can now be optionally configured to predict automatically, which can greatly reduce the amount of effort and time spent triaging. This is something that you'd want to make sure you test and tune before auto-applying, though, just to make sure that it does work in your organization. So essentially, Audit Assistant is a probabilistic thing, and it needs to be trained using issue metadata as well as manual auditing of true or false positive statuses. After it has been trained, you can throw new issues at it, and it will then make predictions based on the training data available. Now, reliability is by default set to an 80% confidence threshold, but this can be toggled to suit the needs of your organization. So another choice that you have with Audit Assistant is in which training data sets you use. So organizations can either use Fortify community data. So this is going to be the metadata and audit data from our manual audits on Fortify on demand, or they can use their own private data. So presumably, if you use your own data, it's going to be more reliable because it is going to be specific to your situation and organization. But the downside here is that you'll need to audit and build that data set first, which can take time. Now, our data set is available and ready for use immediately and can also be used while you build up your own data history. So to train the algorithm further, after you've done a manual audit, you can submit your audits for training and it will be added to our community data. But one thing to keep in mind is that this is a statistical thing, and if you do the same audit next time, your audit may be reflected differently. It just means that the algorithm is only being slightly adjusted based on that data. And this is because the community data set is so large that the statistical effect of a single audit can be very small. Now, if you're using your own data set and the sample size is small, this could have a much bigger effect. But either way, though, this is a great tool to reduce the time and effort that's spent triaging and can apply audits before a human even takes a look at the vulnerabilities. So lastly, and I think most importantly, we have filters. So in my opinion, this is the best first option to reducing noise. This is where I would go first to reduce my noise. So we saw filter files during the scan phase, but you can also apply filters post-scan in either Audit Workbench or Software Security Center. By default, we do ship with two filter sets. So that would be Security Auditor View, which is going to show you all the found issues, and Quick View, which is going to show your criticals and highs, but filter out your lower criticalities for you. So most of my customers use just those, but this can also be fully customized. You can determine what criticality folder vulnerabilities should be classified in. You can set visibility filters to hide issues that maybe you're not interested in. And you can also suppress issues in particular files that aren't relevant to you. This can be a pretty powerful mechanism, and I highly recommend taking a look at it. You can also manage these filter sets in your audit templates. Software Security Center will allow custom audit templates that can then be applied to any new projects that you may come up with. This is a great way to tweak Fortify to show the results that are kind of based on your or your organization's interests. Now, if you're using Fortify on demand, much of this is done already for you behind the scenes. Fortify on demand, it defines its own filter sets. So these are filter sets that you'd be able to see if you were to download an FPR file and then open it within Audit Workbench. Fortify on demand also uses Audit Assistant to auto predict true and false positives, but you can also have the manual human audit if you do choose to do so by selecting manual. Now, noise can be relatively lower for our Fortify on-demand customers as we do much of this behind the scenes before your organization takes a look at anything. But as I mentioned earlier, there are additional steps for those customers that they can take to reduce noise even further. So to summarize, the key message here is that human review is something that you can and definitely should do with Fortify, but it should be the last thing that you guys do. So human review can be costly in both time and effort, and there are things that we can do before human review just to make the noise more manageable. So before we get to human review, I suggest trying filtering before scanning if it's applicable. Applying post-scan filters to weed down the results to a more manageable set, and also utilizing Audit Assistant to automatically apply audit predictions. If these things are used correctly, these tools will greatly reduce the noise that Fortify creates and hopefully make using Fortify a more pleasant experience for everybody involved. So I'd like to say thank you for listening, and be sure to hit subscribe for more great Fortify news, updates, and how-tos.